I think one of the most important nuances and most difficult, I think, aspects of treating glaucoma is to find out what pressure is perfect for every patient. Now, it's called target pressure. So if you go to your eye doctor's office and the doctor says you have glaucoma, okay, well, what does my pressure have to be? The problem is everybody's disease, everybody's eye requires a different pressure. So how do we figure that out? Well, a lot of it's based upon where did you start with? From where you started with, we want a certain reduction of pressure, but it also depends on how advanced you are. The more nerve damage you have, the more visual field loss we have, the lower that target pressure has to be to maintain whatever we have left. I always tell patients, we have a bucket of nerves. We can lose 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60% of those nerves and have no significant loss of field. But once we reach that critical threshold, any further loss of those nerve fibers causes a significant worsening of our vision. And so therefore, we want to protect ourselves from getting to that stage. Unfortunately, once we're at that stage where we've lost enough nerve fibers, it takes more aggressive treatment, lower pressures to keep those nerves stable and prevent them from getting worse. So in a nutshell, it's where to begin with, how advanced we are, which determines how low the pressures have to be. And then once we get you to that pressure, then we see how stable you are. Looking at the nerves, looking at the visual fields, if things are stable, we've done our job. If they're still progressing at that target pressure that we have, sometimes we have to adjust that pressure and get it even lower. So target pressures may move over time, depending on how stable you are. Hope that helped.
Leaving with glaucoma, people sometimes get to the point where they have expectations of visual improvement over time. But I think it's important to realize what glaucoma is, which is a progressive optic nerve deterioration as a result of many factors, but high eye pressure being one of the factors that we deal with. What happens with glaucoma is that vision loss directly from glaucoma is irreversible. And so our goal when we treat glaucoma patients is to try and maintain the vision that they have. In treating glaucoma, we use different modalities, whether it's drops, lasers, or surgeries to help to control pressure so that we have a better control of the eye pressure and prevent progression of glaucoma. In the event that we stop taking our eye medication, what then happens is that pressure stays high and we lose more vision. So our expectation should not be to get improved vision with the use of medication, but should be to maintain what we have because that's what our goals are when we treat glaucoma. So my advice is don't stop your drops because your vision doesn't improve because our goal is to maintain what you have and prevent you from further vision loss.
It's really important with the family history of glaucoma to make sure that the rest of your family knows about it. And there's a couple of reasons why. And I really spend time at diagnosis speaking to patients about this because it's so important. First of all, we know that approximately 50% or half of the people in the United States and worldwide, it's probably worse, that have glaucoma don't know that they have it because they haven't had an eye exam. When you have a family history, if you even can just tell your children or grandchildren that, hey, I have this disease and we think there's a big genetic component to it. So just encouraging your kids to get an eye exam. And I can't tell you how many children and grandchildren of my patients I now see, some because of glaucoma, but some just because I've gotten to know them through their parents and grandparents. So the second part of that is the support mechanism. Glaucoma is a chronic disease, and it's a great example of a chronic medical disease such as diabetes or high blood pressure, arthritis. All of these diseases, you know, you can't really cure. And in glaucoma, what we're trying to do is get patients to be able to take their medications and keep their appointments and keep a healthy lifestyle and to have the family engaged in that to know what the eventual outcome could be if it's not controlled and taken care of and managed. It lets everybody buy into the process. And I found a good family support is a key metric in the outcomes of our patients with glaucoma.